great to see you all here. Thanks so much for coming. Thought I'd just talk you through a little bit about what's going to go on. So these things are grouped together. So this first Britain piece is actually going to be performed the whole thing without any applause or anything. So these first eight, you'll have to wait to the end if you like it, which you might not because it's a little So just to give you a warning that if you, at intermission, which is going to be 10 minutes, by the way, feel like you didn't really connect with that first set, just know that it gets a little bit easier for you in the second half, so stick around. And then we'll do this group. We'll take like 30 seconds between each, but again, the German to be performed together without applause. The three barber without applause, and anything goes sort of with that last set. So, yeah, without further ado, here we go.
And the roof lamps that his spirit was gone, I thought, this is you, and spoke thereupon. I think, said the vicar, our ransom is quicker than vials out of doors in these frosts and pores. That old-fashioned way requires a fine day, and it seems to me it had better not be. Hence that afternoon, though never knew he that his wish could not be, to get through it faster, they buried the master without any tune. But 'twas said that when at the dead of next night the vicar looked out, there struck on his ken from
one tis, and
Yeah. Thank you.
knows this or not, but there's going to be a gathering at the Mad Capper after this. So I know that we're sort of here after hours, so congregate and sort of make your way down there. And thanks for coming, I guess. And we'll see you down there.
Great.
I hated that market on 10th Street. Digging through junk's not a hobby of mine. But I knew if I rolled out of bed by 9:30 and hopped on the subway by 10, then I might get the chance to spend half of my morning seeing you there. After we met, I would stop by that bakery up on 7th, real upscale. And I have to admit that I hated that bakery. The staff was pretentious, the cupcakes were stale, but I knew if we'd fought I could show the next morning a slice of peach cobbler in hand, and you'd open the door and I'd finish my penance seeing you there. I made it perfectly clear when we met I did not like the parks in this town. If we wanted a field, I would find us a real one upstate. But you had that bench down in Washington Square, surrounded by concrete and bums everywhere. But I said that I'd meet you there, told you I'd run a bit late. Well, actually, I was on time, only standing there, watching you wait. Then like something in a movie, the sunlight hits your face, the wind picks up your hair, flutters and dances towards the sky. You turn your head, my heart sputters, and I don't know why. I think I might cry, 'cause there I was standing agape in a park in the city. Usually something I can't bear, but with you there, the park was this magical landscape. It's true they were hippies, but I didn't care, because I was distracted by all of these feelings, exactly what I didn't know. So I searched for the words, and I blurted, "I love you!" I'm not gonna lie, I don't know quite why. Sorry to give you a scare, but I don't know. Maybe it came from just seeing you tidy up the place.
If she were coming back, there's a chance I might even shave my face. And I'd throw on that cologne she gave me at Christmas time last year. But she's not coming back. Not here. It isn't like I need a woman to make me do every single chore. I just need someone to do all those little things for. If she were on her way, I'd pop that champagne we have on ice. If she were on her way, I'd get our kitchen table looking nice. And I'd make her favorite meal, or whatever it would take to make her stay. But she's not coming home. And she's not coming back. And she's not on her. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep.